Hey, everybody, it's the coach. This is Thursday Night Football on EA Sports. Coming up next, we've got what should be a good one between the Denver Broncos and the Seattle Seahawks. I'll see you again at halftime as we preview some of the action coming up on Sunday. But for now, it's Thursday Night Football. And on the call, as always, it's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
With the beautiful Puget Sound just to our west, you get a look inside CenturyLink Field here in Seattle. This crowd, as we've come to expect in recent years, as loud as any in the NFL, and they get even louder when their Seahawks are introduced. We're ready for football as the Seahawks get set to do battle with the Denver Broncos. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, you look at this Seahawks team as they get ready here. And I don't think from what we saw down on the field before the game, there's any doubt they're ready to roll.
They pass the eye test, don't they? This team looks fired up and ready to play.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Broncos, an early season tilt. And when it's an early season tilt, should be ready to roll.
Well, let's face it, the aches and pains haven't really set in yet. And both teams eyeing a really good start to get things going.
As a Pro Bowler, as an undrafted rookie, it's Philip Lindsay. They find some open field here. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That good for 22 and a first down. They went with the nickel look defensively, so they had five defensive backs in there. Didn't help them stop the run.
Yeah, I love that, the nickel look. 5 cents, five DBs. But what also happens then? You take a big body off the field in order to insert that guy. So you're taking a big off for a little. And oftentimes, you can run the football effectively against that defense.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Off the play fake, Angel. And that's complete to the tight end, Heierman. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. And this is a guy straight out of college. They're not going to try to groom for a year or two. They want him to produce right away.
That's why they took him in the first round. They expect him to be a starter right away and a future All-Pro. So they don't have any time to wait for him to come along. They want him to play right now to help this team.
And you take a look at this draft class from a season ago, really it grades out as a pretty darn good class.
So you have to give a lot of credit to the entire scouting organization, general manager, personnel department, college scouts. It all came together. They evaluated it very well and got a nice payoff.
They'll run here with Lindsay. Not much there. Maybe a couple as he's taken down at the 40.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Here's second and 8. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Jake Butt, the tight end, his intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
And darn right, they did something to disrupt that timing.
Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. So first possession, fourth and short. Field goal's no gimme from here. What do you think about going for it?
I'm not.
First and 10, Angel. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Philip Lindsay, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
Throwing again, Angel. Sanders has it over the middle. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. 23 yards the pick up there. Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, stepping back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
This will be caught at about the 6. No gain there on the completion. It'll be... So this one will wind up a Denver victory. And say what you want about CenturyLink Field up in Seattle, but for my money, this is the loudest and most difficult place to win in the league.
It's very hard. The fan support, off the charts. The way that they make noise and understand when to make noise, they understand the game as well as anyone. And how about what we get in our media packets when we start preparing for the game? They have it in their own stuff, right? The number of offsides penalties, false start penalties that they draw against the opposing team because of that fan support. And last but not least, they designed the stadium to keep the noise in, and it works.
But not in this one. They were able to somehow come in here and get that victory. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. Once you're ready, go ahead and select Advance Week to get to your next game. Cooking up, gourmet, I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cooking up, gourmet, I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. I don't wear ball, mains. Start your week by installing your game plan. Power up and level up at any moment. Spitting like a semi, only give me semicolon. Couple zeros like I'm sending yell nets. Every flow is unmatched and I better get set in. Finish him, finish him. Mess around with me and I diminish them all. Even if I ever did the minimum all. In the end result, I better kill them all. Rogue one, but I got a team with me. Batman when I got a thing with me. I get mean, I get green. Show the whole game what's never been seen. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Designer sneakers hurt my feet now. Every beat is getting beat down. Couldn't eat, well watch I eat now. Like how you getting paid to freestyle? Different cities every week now. Every woman is a now. With state prop, you looking bleak now. I was home to sleep, designing sheets now. 30 different missions. When I speak, they listen. Couldn't find the social fishing. Who the crew? It wasn't you. I know it's true, cause you look like the opposition. Run it up, greatest ever sums it up. I ain't have a lot when I was coming up. Kinda made my stomach turn when I brought.
Today's a work day, gentlemen, and you know what that means? We gotta get better today. What I wanna know is who's ready to work? I'm ready to work. Are you ready to work? If you are, then go out and prove it to me. Show me what you got.
Here we go. 60 orange. Let's go. Hey, how fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin'. You look like you need a timeout. I'm a star in the clutch. I'm a shine out. Work hard. I'm back on my grind now. Game one took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings. I just wanna play off. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I got a
Randy Moss, yeah, my numbers going up. Hey. All these trophies, what do I need anymore?
Ready.
For? Check the stats up, you can check the scoreboard. Check the stats, Jay Critch, I'm the QB. Hey. Ran it up and then I went and got a new freeze. Hey. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team bowling, you look
come
like
on,
you need
Jack.
A timeout.
Dippy.
I'm a star
hey.
In the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Hey. Game on,
take
a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft.
Hey, you know what, guys? That was pretty dang good. And you know what gets me really excited? You haven't even reached the top of your potential yet. Not even close. Each and every one of you should take that as a challenge and see if you can find that next level.
If you ain't a winner, then don't come round. On my way to another city, it's a touchdown. Under late, yeah, I gotta get it in a rush now. Let them hate, try to knock me down, but we got up now. You said that you ballin', keep it real, though. Why I never saw you in the field, though?
Why?
Hey, I make it look easy, it's a field goal. I've been grinding for a minute and I'm still going. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star in the clutch, I'm a shine.
Hey everybody, it's the coach, and this is Monday Night Football on EA Sports. On tap, we've got what should be a fairly intriguing matchup between the San Francisco 49ers and the Denver Broncos. I'll be back at halftime to look at some of these stats and scores from Sunday's action. But for now, it's Monday Night Football. And to call the action, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the foot of the Rockies, just west of downtown Denver at Broncos Stadium at Mile High. A moment ago, through a shower of pyrotechnics, it was the hometown Broncos taking the... Here on first down. Man open. He's got it complete to Cortland Sutton. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. They'll run for the first time with Philip Lindsay. And he's got this one across midfield into 49er territory. DeForest Buckner in on the tackle.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
On first down, Angel. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. And as a first rounder, a lot of eyes on him, a lot of expectations.
And he has to play well in his rookie year. Those days of coddling guys and bringing them along slowly, those days are long gone. When you're drafted in the first round, they expect you to play right away. In the community's eyes and fan base, they'll be on you the entire way.
They added a lot of talent to a roster that really needed an infusion of youth. They got a very good infusion of youth.
And they didn't really reach to get anyone as well. They stuck to their draft philosophy, got the best players they could at the time they were drafting, and inserted them into their lineup.
And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes this one down to the 15. They're able to convert with a gain of 4. If you make the stop there, maybe you hold them to 3 on this opening drive. They didn't get the stop.
Yeah, new set of downs now. Now you're worried about, just as you pointed out, not just giving up 3, possibly giving up 6. Let's see what they decide to do here, because they've got to change up what they have been doing. It hasn't been working.
On first down, right back to Lindsey. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Well, it didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
That's complete right around the 8. The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
On 3rd down, it's Freeman, and he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. Just a yard, but that's all they needed, and by the slimmest of margins, it'll be 1st and goal. A stop there on 3rd, they could have held him to 3 on this opening drive. Now they have to bow their necks on 1st and goal.
And if I'm looking at this from the offense's point of view, that's a big-time pickup right there, and I'd go right at him with another momentum play. I'd go quickly and attack him, because right...
And caught by Sanders. Touchdown, Broncos. 4 yards on the touchdown grab, and the Broncos take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. A long opening drive, but a very successful opening drive. We call that methodical, I guess, when it takes that many plays.
Methodical? And almost like a boxing match where you're hitting them with...
Here we go! 6 points. Hey, 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 hey!
They'll start on the ground with Lindsey. He'll have a 1st down past the 40. And all the way up to the 45-yard line. Now he may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a 1st down. Now a play fake here on 1st down. And he hits his target, Deshaun Hamilton. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on 1st down. On 1st and 10, it's Lindsey, and he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up, because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
To throw on 2nd down, Angel, he's got Jake Butt, his tight end. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game, because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
Back to throw. Angel, that is caught inside the 5. A well-executed 22-yard gain. Made goal line offense a priority on the practice field this week. This is exactly the situation they've been prepping for. They'll run with Lindsey. And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. And nothing special there. They show they were going to run the football. They ran it. They got it in.
Like old-time football, right? Hey, this is exactly what we're going to do. Straight-ahead power, and they got it done.
Commence with a run by Lindsey. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven past the 30 to the 32. Now we've got whistles and a timeout here. Yeah, it looks like we've got a 49er that's down on the field. Definitely the last thing you want to see here in a preseason game. We'll be right back. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Off play action. Angel under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Boom! That's how we do it, baby.
An extra DB for the 49ers now on third. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. Throwing on third and long, Angel. Eluding the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. Apart from Kyler Murray, not too many mobile QBs in this year's rookie class, but some good scrambling there to get the first.
How many times do we hear that third down may be the most important down in football? And there's no better example than what we just saw right there. Forced to scramble, knows where the first down marker is, dives for it, and gets it. What a big time play, putting his body on the line to pick up a key first down.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
It's a first down on a gain of 10.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
Looking to throw. Angel throwing the out route and complete. That's Hamilton. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Second and five after the 5-yard completion on first down. Second and five. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Sanders. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A first down there on a pickup of 25. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
Takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to read those up.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Emmanuel Sanders in the final seconds of the first half, and the Broncos will extend their lead.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about, and still put the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. Well, Charles, exciting to the very end. That's what we just saw in this game. Final play there, had it in the red zone, but anytime you're outside of the 10, that's tough. Try to draw up a final play to get in, and they couldn't do it.
It certainly is. So what they were looking for was, you know, extra time. Too bad it's not FIFA soccer, right, where you get a little bit of extra and you get a chance to run them a couple more plays and maybe get closer and take that last shot into the end zone.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Broncos are winners, as we say so long from Denver.
Snoop Dogg out of Madden League. His team is off the hook and you don't really want none, but if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy and tell the